Welcome back. We are here again with Greg Brannon to talk more about his beginning his career here at South Carolina. We mentioned that he runs senior semester with a little bit of help, and he also he also runs the live sports production class that just started up last semester here at South Carolina. So starting off, tell us a little bit about the day-to-day when it comes to senior semester and what you were really there to help the kids out with.
Yeah, and I was, you know, the senior semester is really what attracted me here to the university. You know, I loved what I was doing with the Panthers, wasn't necessarily looking for a change. Again, had an opportunity to kind of see what that program was all about. Rick Peterson does a terrific job. You know, he's been here for, you know, two decades. And we run a newsroom, you know, and that's the long and short of it. We're doing a daily newscast. We've got a website that we're running, and we've got social media platforms that we run. So, you know, our daily schedule is, you know, very similar to what it would be in a professional newsroom. We have a morning editorial meeting. Producers run in the meeting. We have reporters. We have our web editor. Everybody's deciding what stories the reporters are going to cover. And then, boom, everybody takes off. And then we have deadlines in the afternoon, and we do a live 30-minute newscast at 4 o'clock. Depending on the semester, sometimes it's two newscasts, one at 4, one at 4:30. And then we come back the next day and we do it again, which is why that really gets into that routine of what it would be like to be a professional journalist. And we do that the entire semester, Monday through Friday. You know, every day we're here, we're doing news. And same thing with the website, we're populating the website with content. So that's really what we do in senior semester. It's four classes rolled into one, basically. And in addition to Rick Peterson, again, who's kind of that senior guy of the group, Carolyn Click and Scott Farron are the other two instructors. And it's a fun group to work with, and we have a lot of fun.
And you also teach the live sports production class that is held at Williams-Brice Stadium. Yeah. Talk to us about that class and kind of how it works, what you really teaching the kids there.
Yeah, so it was brand new last spring. And you know, part of me coming down here because of my sports background, the journalism school really wanted to see what we could do working with the athletic department, because they have a lot of great stuff going over there that would really be beneficial to our students. So the idea was, what can we do from a live sports production standpoint, expose students to what it's, you know, like to do a live sports production? You know, with ESPN3 and ESPN+ and the SEC Network, all these things you see, you don't just snap your fingers and there's a game on television, right? So that's what the live sports production class is. It's a small class, only 20 students. You were one of my students. He did okay. But literally, from learning how to build a camera kit, you know, and build a tripod, and how do you wrap a cable up, and what's the difference between a Tri-X and a BNC and an XLR, and then the class culminates as a crew for a live sports production. And last spring we did two beach volleyball games that actually aired on the SEC Network, so it was kind of cool, and that's really what it is.
And the common thing between these two classes that you have started to teach is that it covers both sides of the camera, you know, what's going on behind the scenes and what's going on in front of it. And in your career, you've done that as well, dealt with everything behind the scenes and in stuff in front of the camera. Speaking of the importance of that for people trying to come up in broadcast journalism and how important it is to know what's going on behind the camera if you want to be in front of it.
I tell our students in senior semester all the time in the live sports production class, if you have an understanding of what it takes to do this, not just sitting here, but behind the camera, in the control room, you're gonna be much better when you are in front of the camera. You know, and I had that opportunity to be an anchor and a reporter, but also learn how to be a really good producer, which ultimately is what led me to the Panthers job. So I think the more you understand the business, the better you are at the different aspects of the business, the better you are gonna be if you wanna be on camera. And I really encourage people, if you wanna be an anchor, be a really good reporter first. If you wanna be a really good reporter, learn how to produce. To me, it all goes together. So live sports production class, there's really no on air, right? We have a guest speaker come in who talks a little bit about being on air, but it's not about on air. It's about working behind the scenes, and you know, when you put on the gloves and you go to work and you're sweating, you're digging trenches for cables and all that kind of stuff. But to that end, that's why we've started, or we're working on starting a new class, a sports live, what are we calling it? Live sports broadcasting, which is play-by-play. So it's an independent study. This semester we have the first four students going through it, and they're learning how to broadcast sporting events. So, you know, play-by-play, color, and we'll see how that goes.
So this is really preparing you for the real world, real life experiences in the classroom here. How beneficial do you think that is for the students, and any success stories that you could share with us?
Oh, absolutely. I think it's very beneficial. As a matter of fact, David Cockfield is the director of live productions with the athletic department. And just this past year, he's got three different students who, former students now, who have gone on to work with ESPN. And one of them, Jenny Warren, is up in Bristol, and she's one of their technical directors. And the reason she was able to get that job coming out of school is because she had done, I don't even know the number, but it was hundreds or 100 plus games as a technical director, as a TD, switching these live sporting events. And ESPN sees that and goes, well, she's already doing, we don't have to train anybody. And so she got a job. So yeah, absolutely. Now on the play-by-play side, again, very hard to get your foot in the door. You talk to anybody who wants to do play-by-play, it's not easy. You know, you need opportunity, you need reps. I always talk about getting reps. I mean, that's kind of one of those sports terms. You've got to do it, right? Yeah. The only way to get good at hosting a show is to host a show, right? And it's the same thing in broadcasting. The only way to get better as a reporter, go report. The only way to get better as an anchor, you anchor. The only way to get better as a play-by-play guy, do games.
Got to call play-by-play.
Absolutely. And there's something magical about when that red light goes on. Okay, you can sit in front of your mirror at home all you want to, practicing, but when that red light goes on and you know you're live and now you've actually got to do it, that's a whole different thing. So yes, we're trying to give students real-world experience, and it absolutely helps. And I go back to senior semester, there's literally a list hanging on the wall of dozens and dozens of students who've gone through the program who got jobs coming out of school in TV.
And that's, I think, something that's very special about the School of Journalism here. It's a very unique program in senior semester. And the School of Journalism does almost everything it can with the teachers they hire, obviously, that have a background in what they're doing, that they set these kids up to be successful. You talk about like live sports production. They hired, I think, at least four or five of the students that I was with to work for their live sports production. Mm-hmm. And as far as senior semester goes, you see people go off and get jobs right out of graduation, yep. Whether it's to, you know, reporting jobs in Duluth, Minnesota, or Texas, but you can see the success that's there, and I think that's what's special about, especially the senior semester program, because you don't really see that in schools across the country.
Well, and that's, again, what attracted me, you know, down here to South Carolina. You know, there are great journalism schools all over the country. I've not found, you know, in similar programs, but nothing quite what we're doing here. And I do think, you know, the proof of that is the quality of journalists that are graduating from this school. And they're going on to get jobs and to work and to do really, really well. I mean, national media, a lot of local media. And to me, that just says a lot about the quality of students that are coming through and then the quality of education that they get as they're trained to be journalists and then those opportunities to actually practice being journalists.
And if there's one thing that you could tell someone trying to come up in journalism, whether it's, you know, through broadcast on, you know, media or paper, what is one piece of advice you would give to journalists coming up about having to work through, you know, to pay their dues and having to get up to before they become successful?
Yeah, the key word is work. I mean, you've got to be willing to work. You know, everybody looks and says, I want your job. Well, okay, take my job, what it took to get to the Panthers. I didn't just graduate from Ohio State and say, hey, I'm going to go work for an NFL football team. Again, I went from Ohio to Maryland to West Virginia to Virginia. You have to go through that process, and it makes you better. You just got to be willing to work. I mean, you really do. To learn every day and to be a good journalist, be a storyteller, because it doesn't matter what the medium is, the platform, whether it's television or web or social media or radio, we're storytellers. You've got to learn how to be a storyteller. And there's a lot involved with that to be really good storytellers. Be good journalists, and it takes work. You're not going to coast. There are too many other people who want to do it.
Well, we had a great storyteller with us here today, Greg Brannon. Really appreciate the time. It was a pleasure.
My pleasure.
And until next time, South Carolina.
Straight up.